birthday. And how old are you? How old did you get yesterday?
Hi, Charlotte. I'm good. I'm fine. I have this is my birthday. I'm 43. I think it was
43,
like
43.
42 years old, and it was 7 my birthday.
Yes, yesterday, 7th of May. So you're a tourist. And I've got another friend that is a tourist as well. I know a few tourists. And well, I hope you've had a nice day. It was full moon in Libra yesterday. Did you do anything with that because it was full moon? How did you celebrate your birthday at this time with the crisis? Did you join with friends or did you do it on your own?
Met one friend, I go outside in the nature, and we have a full moon blessing.
All
We
right.
have, yeah.
So what did you do? How do you do the blessing?
The blessing, yeah. We have fire, campfire.
Okay.
We have met wierook.
With joss sticks.
We have the drum.
You've got the drum, and what do you use the drum for?
The drum, yeah, for like so bum 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 and bum bum bum, the rhythm from the music, and we sing together, and rituals. Together we do rituals. Just we
Rituals,
rituals.
rituals.
Sorry,
No, you're
and.
doing speaking very well. Good, good. But practice makes perfect.
And we write on paper our wishes, our Wenzen,
Wishes, wishes. Yeah. You wrote your wishes for the full moon. Yeah. On paper.
we burn it in the fire and let it go to Mother Nature and into the universe that. Ja, de weer zeg maar alle gods en ze kan hier ons
So Wendy's saying she wrote her wishes on a piece of paper, then burned it in the fire, and then it blew up and went into the energy of Mother Nature and to all the gods. So they put their wishes in there, and so that the gods knows their wishes. So it will take it up in the universe energy, or the energy of the universe, and that it will flow. And that is what the full moon does, is the really strong energy. But now it's a day later, and the moon is waning now. It's going down, going on to the next stage.
Dus we kunnen weer positief flow in en de positieve energie, de flow en see hear us en ja en the universe can work it.
Work it out. Okay. Well, I hope to be there next year just to do a bit with the witches as well. I would love to do that. Remember, you're invited by Monica Brovinsky from the House of Shadows and Shadowlands. I'm waiting for that deck. That's a tarot deck. We've been invited to go in October to Canada to join a witches festival.
Okay. Oh, very nice. Thank you.
I'll tell her. Okay. So we're going to start doing the cards again from Marla Brooks. Okay, we're going to do the pentagram first.
Yeah,
Okay. That
lovely.
is, you've got that in where? Oh yes, there. The
Yeah.
pentagram. Yeah, I love that. It's nice, isn't it?
On my back, I have
A big
a
one.
big one, and met live trees, and the triple moon, and the pentagram inside it. Allemaal on, yeah,
Oh
that
well,
is.
take a photo of it and let's see next week.
I have it. Yeah, I do.
Okay, great. But I like that pentagram. It's much softer and much more circular than this. It looks more like the pentagram in a web, like a spider's web.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Pentagram. The pentagram is an ancient symbol, and to many, it is seen as a symbol of faith and protection. The upward point of the star is representative of the spirit. The other four points all represent the elements of earth, air, fire, and water. All these things contribute to life and are a part of each of us. Earth represents stability and physical endurance. Fire depicts courage and daring. Water represents emotions and intuition. Air relates to intelligence and the arts. And spirit represents the deity and the divine and the all that is. The star is a circle by a wheel representing the continual flow of life and energy. The meaning. Draw from this card's energy. It is mind and spirit over matter. Any obstacles that are in your way can easily be removed at this time. Trace the pentagram on this card with your index finger. This allows you to use your will to make things happen. Now, for those that don't have the cards, then take any pentagram and go around the pentagram with your finger and just say the incantation that I'm going to read to you in a minute, and I will do it slowly. So if you would like to get a grab a piece of paper and a pencil, then you can write it down. But the gemstone for this card is smoky quartz. That's my crystal ball.
Mm-hmm.
Smoky quartz is a synthesis of the four elements. It is grounding and protective, like the pentagram, too. Use the crystal to banish unwanted energies and clear obstacles from your path. Incantation. So here it goes, guys. Write this down if you want. No harm shall pass. I'll repeat it. No harm shall pass, says the five-pointed star.
Mm-hmm.
Says the five-pointed star. Harness my energy. Harness my energy. And then you'll go far. And then you'll go far. Your will you must use to quickly evict. I'll repeat that. Your will you must use to quickly evict all the things that are now derelict. All things that are now derelict. Okay, I'll repeat the whole sentence. No harm shall pass, says the five-pointed star. Harness my energy, and then you'll go far. Your will you must use to quickly evict all the things that are now derelict.
How beautiful.
Yeah, I think so too.
I love the pentagram. Nou, deze kaart die duidt aan dat voor jou dit is voor jou als het ware een wegwijzer. Zo moet je dat zien.
This pentagram is showing you the way.
Ja. Het wordt ingezet wat je wil. Kan je tot uiting laten komen?
The pentagram shows you the way to what you want and to get the results. So that it can come true or can come out.
Ja, het zal je de juiste weg wijzen. Zodat jij de juiste pad in mag slaan en werk samen met alle elementen.
This shows you the way, so that you, wat zei je nou?
Zodat je de juiste pad in mag slaan en dat je kan werken met deze elementen.
So that you'll be on the right path, that you'll take the right path and that you work with all the elements.
De elementen waar de pentagram voor staat, hè?
Ja. like earth, fire, water and air.
Ja. Ja, dat is de basis van ons bestaan, ons leven. Ja.
That's the basis, the base of our life. Now we're going to a lovely card. I love this card. And that's the phoenix. The phoenix rising from the ashes. Ooh, new start.
Yeah.
Phoenix. The phoenix is a mystical and magical creature with an extremely long lifespan. In Greek mythology, the phoenix is... cyclically regenerated or reborn. Associated with the sun, a phoenix obtains new life by arising from the ashes of its predecessor. It is a symbol of immortality and resurrection and reminds us that the end is only the beginning. In ancient Egypt, the phoenix was also a symbol and metaphor for the setting and rising sun. The sun disappears beneath the western horizon in the ball of flames when its daily journey is completed, so that it may be reborn anew in the east the following morning by the way of a new ball of fire. Ooh, and I get that song, The Ball of Fire.
Yeah.
I love that film. That was the Rollerblades or something, the film was called. When you draw this card, the phoenix stands as a metaphor for being reborn. This can either manifest in picking yourself up when you are down and making the changes that need to be made, a shaking off those shackles that have been holding you back. The phoenix is letting you know that it's no matter how difficult things may be right now, you will soon be reborn and start anew. The crystal is petrified wood. Petrified wood, like all fossils, is the perfect symbol of rebirth and fresh starts. Once living things give way to minerals, thus rendering them durable, eternal, and magical, work with the petrified wood or other fossils to help you let go of the past to build the future of your dreams. The incantation is, I will rise from the ashes, refreshed and renewed. The scars left behind will no longer be viewed. I'll be fit, I'll be strong, and in charge of my life. I'll be happy to ward off the world full of strife.
Yeah,
strife is really a folk language in London. It's called Cockney. And there's strife. Like apples and pears is upstairs.
Okay, yeah.
Strife means trouble.
Ja, mooi. Mooie vogel, hè?
Ja, dat is goed voor een tattoo.
My good friend, he has a tattoo on his shoulder to his borst. Hè? So
from
his chest, from there to there. Right. And he has a phoenix and echt beautiful. Very right. Nice.
Well, it's nice. It is nice for a tattoo. It really is nice. It's awesome.
Yeah, and his tattoo is echt perfect. Echt very nice. Yeah. And the phoenix staat voor een wedergeboorte.
The phoenix stands for a rebirth.
En het is eigenlijk herpak je. Doe wat je doen moet in het leven. Blijf niet hangen in het negatieve.
Do what you have to do. If you've fallen over, stand up and dust yourself off and start again.
Ja. Zet door, hoe moeilijk het ook is. Het is een nieuwe start voor je.
Carry on, even if it is really difficult at the moment. So start that new start now.
Ja. En je voelt je daarna gewoon echt weer herboren. Gewoon. Super.
After that, you will be rejuvenated and feel great.
Yeah.
Okay, the next one is the raven.
Mm.
Ooh, that's really eerie.
Yeah. It's a beautiful card, up with a purple color.
Ah, the purple is spiritual.
Yeah.
And the ravens are in the London Tower. They're really sacred animals.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're very wise birds.
Yeah, I love it.
Ravens are commonly associated with bad omens, tidings of death, sorrow and destruction. But a great deal of ancient symbols associated with this bird is positive. The raven is thought to be the most prophetic of all birds, and its intelligence is said to be quite high. It is a symbolic of mind, thought and wisdom. Ravens are often seen as messengers between heaven and earth, and they are believed to carry messages back and forth from the higher plane. The meaning of the card: this is important that you hear the cry of the raven and open up your mind to the world on the other side of the veil. The wisdom of the ancestors and those who have gone before is there for the taking, if you just take the time to listen to what they have to say. Let them know they are not forgotten, and embrace the knowledge they will offer. Ask them a question and they will give you an answer. The gemstone is red jasper. Since jasper is a sedimentary stone, it symbolizes the accumulation of wisdom, karma, and lessons over the passage of time. Red jasper calls to our ancestral memories and stirs them within our blood. Meditate with red jasper when you have the need to communicate with your own ancestors. The incantation is: my ears are open, so please do speak. It's your ancient wisdom I now seek. I give thanks to you on bended knee, because if there were no you, there would be no me.
Yeah, beautiful. I love this card. Yeah. I have the raven and the
nice one.
Yeah. De raven staat voor open je gedachten en kijken in de wereld.
The raven, according to Wendy, stands for open your mind and look into the world.
Observeer alles om je heen en luister en krijg de boodschappen door.
Look around you, listen what's happening and make sure that you understand and get the messages.
Hey, je krijgt antwoorden, maar sta wel stil met alles en open je.
You will get the answers, but stand still and think and open yourself up.
He, je gedachten, je krijgt er kracht weer voor terug. Hè? Dus werken met gedachtenkracht, zeg maar. En doordat je werkt met gedachtenkracht, krijg je er heel wat voor terug en alleen het positieve.
With the power of thought, you will gain a lot of information and you will gain a lot of power.
Ja,
and waarom, wisdom.
Het is in principe is het zo van, hè, je hebt de raven van Odin, is de gedachte, zeg maar. En
Odin is een god, toch?
Ja. Ja, klopt.
This is, Wendy said, the raven also stands for the god Odin. And Odin is the hanged man. The hanged man is get a different perspective, meditation. Wow, that Odin. Odin was a man that got bored and he decided to hang up himself upside down in meditative state to get another perspective. And through that, he got wisdom.
And the raven van Odin... En de raven of Odin staan voor gedachten en voor, ik had een naam.
It stands for thought, yeah.
Gedachte en geheugen.
And memory, thought and memory. Okay. Lovely card.
Yeah.
And the last card for this week, we have Salamander.
Yeah.
Salamander. I never knew witches worked with salamanders. No, not really. The salamander is a diverse and unorthodox creature. The symbolic meaning of the salamander is fire. They like living inside rotting logs. They are sometimes gathered and burned. When placed in fire, the salamander will attempt to escape from the log, thus creating an impression that it is created from flames. They regrow their tail and limbs if lost in near missed bites from other predators or other calamities. This is a symbolic of renewal, regeneration, rebirth, and growth. It is a message that there is never total loss, and you must seek out renewal whenever possible. The meaning of this card: the salamander comes to those who are in need of change in their lives and asks us to evolve. These magical creatures will reveal to you how the energy of your will can be used to alter and recreate the environment around you. Change isn't always cheerful, it's sometimes we often fear, but when the salamander appears, these changes are meant to be meaningful, positive, and enlightening. Perceive the changes going on around you and adapt to your best ability rather than fighting against them. The gemstone is fire opal. Fire opal warms and vivid color Belize is watery composition. A juxtaposition resembling that of a salamander itself. The gem boosts confidence, enhances creativity. It fuels your growth on virtually every level. Use the gem to overcome fear of change and expand your horizons. And that is what it looks like. I don't know whether you can see it. It's a bit fiery and orangey.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, I see it.
You really need to get the deck because it's so beautiful and it's so many cards and you've got so many things this. Okay. Incantation: what once seemed lost can be replaced. All things can be retraced. I embrace the changes. They will serve me well. All fear and negativity, I now do expel.
Ja, nice card. Deze kaart die duidt aan, zeg maar, dat je moet veranderen in het leven en evolueren.
This card means that you have to change in your life and you have to evaluate.
Je zal een positieve verandering aangaan. Dat duidt deze kaart ook aan. Het positieve energie komt op je pad.
This means that the change will be positive. And positive energy will cross your path.
Vecht tegen het negatieve om je heen. En zet deze om in het positieve, zodat jij alleen jezelf kan zijn.
Fight against negativity and turn the negativity into positive. So that you can be yourself.
Ja, dus deze kaart voor.
Wow, nice one.
Ja.
Okay, thank you very much for that, Wendy.
Een salamander hadden wij een tijdje terug in de zandbak.
Really? Yeah. Wendy says she had a salamander in the sandpit, the children's sandpit.
En he was in diepe sleep.
Yes, He was hibernating.
Yeah.
Okay, and he was in deep sleep. Wow. And what did you do with it?
Went to sleep.
Oh, went to sleep. And what did you do with it? Did you leave it there?
No, I pick it up and leaves in a rock there.
Oh, you put them in the rock and the leaves somewhere else. You replace them. Okay.
Mine is now gone.
Oh, he's gone now. Okay.
This is a good sign for me.
Yes, a lucky sign. Good.
Yeah.
Well, that's lovely. Well, thank you very much for coming together this week. I hope to see you next week again. Take care. God bless. And give love to the boys. Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye. Bye.
Thank you. Ciao.
Bye.